internationally known. When I be on the mic. So, coach. I'm internationally known, yo.
Relieved? Excited? Tell us what's going on.
I'm definitely relieved. It's just a lot of work. And after it's over, it's just like, you think back of all the work that you put in, and then it's like, oh, it paid off.
You still like on cloud nine right now?
No, I don't know that I ever was on cloud nine. Like, I was just kind of...
We were talking about that earlier.
Yeah.
It's like, once it's over, it's like...
It's like
it lasts for like a couple hours.
Yeah, and then it's just like. Yeah, I think it was different. I don't know. I think it was different.
We had a little bit more struggle.
Like, yeah, I felt like we struggled more this year. Not, I mean, the game just felt tighter, felt closer, and I don't know if it's that we were not as good as we were last year. Or the competition was better. I don't know. I feel like in middle school.
Sixth grade, like seventh grade? Like,
yeah, sixth and seventh grade.
Early, yeah.
So yeah, you can tell. And it's more about like being an athlete. It's not necessarily volleyball skills. You can just get so much better. Like you can learn those. I'm not saying that, you know, you can wait till you get to high school. But you with volleyball, it's just more of being athletic, and I just feel like we can teach you everything else. You have to be somewhat athletic and coachable, and you have to really grind at it. I think that the successful programs, like for example, half of our girls play at K2 in Knoxville, the other half play at A5 in Chattanooga. And there's a few that plays locally here at C4, and then there's some that do not play, like Lily O'Brien. She's playing travel softball, so she can't play volleyball, but she's just such a fantastic athlete that when you take those athletes that are not as fine-tuned in volleyball, like you, I mean, you're going to have them in a position, and they're gonna be successful.
And we talked about that a little bit in the first one. Like Lily's jam is softball. She's a softball. I mean, you're going to have those athletes that are like that, but
Lily could go to college in volleyball too.
Yeah,
yeah, for sure. Yeah, she could play. I think she could play Division I volleyball, maybe mid-major or small D1. But she definitely she's a great volleyball player. We're down 21-17, right. And so like we talk about it like throughout the year, like volleyball it's five sets. Like we train and we do a lot of conditioning, volleyball conditioning, not like sprinting, running, but it has running in it. But we always talk about preparing for five sets because, I mean, if you watch anything, like you watch Wisconsin and Nebraska the other night, it went five sets down to the last point. Like, you know, those are the top teams. I mean, like to not lose a set is, I mean, it's just not likely. But we just talk about, you know, preparing for five sets. Like, okay, they may take a set off of us, but we've got to be prepared. You know, I mean, there's a reason you played a five. No, I called a timeout, and I just said, guys, relax. Like, we've already won the first set. Like, we're up 1-0. Yeah, we've weathered the storm. The first game, getting that out, we're ahead. Whether we're behind on the scoreboard, we're ahead. I would say. You have to be passionate. I mean, that's like, for example, I mean, I can use my daughter. I'm not with everybody else when they're home, but she'll say, I can't wait to go to practice. I'm like, really? Yeah. So, you know,
that's rare.
Yeah.
That's not common.
So we went on Friday. We've been completely exhausted. She slept all day on Saturday. And then Sunday she said, I cannot wait to go. The club tryout, so that she had volleyball club tryouts on Sunday, could not wait to get there with her club teammates. And then like during club, she was like, I can't wait for high school season. Like I can't, like she says, I just love it. Like she can't wait to play the game. She'll be for the game. I can't wait till tonight. I'm like, we're playing like somebody in our district. Like it's not like a district, you know, championship or anything like that. I can't wait. awesome. Yeah. They have to be selfless. And, you know, just putting this year, this team, you know, when we had that kind of, I think, you know, we had the moment in our season where it just, we lost and we just, we wasn't, you know, come in. They just wasn't really focused. I had to walk out of practice. And, so we lost to East Hamilton. We were terrible, absolutely terrible. And it's hard in volleyball what happens, and I don't know the way that wrestling works, but I feel like you have to practice a lot. Like, you got to get, like, Mike Lingenfelter, who's, like, one of the best volleyball coaches in the nation. Like, he's just amazing. But we go to his camps, and he always talks about, like, you know, being ready to get more reps than everybody else. And he's like, if you know, just talking about as a player, like, if I'm ready to go and I'm getting, you know, 300 more reps every practice, then that's, you know, that's 1,000 more reps every week. That's 20,000 more reps than you have. So, like, just being prepared to do that, to get more reps than everybody else. And I feel like volleyball is like that. And so, like, at that point where we were not getting reps, like, we, because you have a game and you have to find that balance between, okay, we've got a game, but we haven't practiced because we've had a game and a game. And it's just the way that volleyball works. Like, we have to play our district, but we have to go play tough competition, like, outside of our district. And so, yeah. I mean, in order to do that, we have to travel and we have to go, you know, to Knoxville, and we have to go all these places. And so it's very hard to practice. And, you know, when Eric was coaching with me, he'd be like, we got to practice. We can't play so many games. But if we don't play games against those really good teams, like, we're not prepared because our district isn't as strong. And so we lost East Hamilton. We were just terrible. And I just said, I'll see y'all at 5:30 in the morning. And so we get there. And so I think we might have had it. No, I don't know if we had a game the next day, but I just said, I'll see y'all at 5:30. We just got to get to work. And was that the time I walked out after the East Ham game? So they were just kind of,
it's like, what are you doing here? Don't you usually have morning practice right now?
You know, they were just kind of going through the motions, and they were talking about, I don't even know. And I was just like, I just had a moment, and I was like, you know, like, y'all are making excuses why you know, you didn't want to be here, this or that. And I said, I'm just,
you got to want for that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so I just said, you know, I'll see y'all at the district tournament. Like, we're not going to do this. And so I think Kinsley, she started running practice. And then when we left, then she said,
she walked out of practice
on me. So I guess when your real leader walks out on you, like, it's like, oh, what are we going to do? And so then after that, I was like, you know what, if you guys don't want it, like, I'm not putting all this time and everything I've got into this something, because you said you wanted it. Like, I mean, I want you guys to win. I want it for you, and I'm going to do everything to get you prepared. But they had to put in the work. And I said, you're the one that said that you would sacrifice your social life. You would sacrifice going, you know, to all your football games and sleep and all this stuff. They told me that. And so I said, you're the one that said it. I didn't. I've already done that. I've already been there. I've already sacrificed all that. So I was willing to go with you guys, and you're not willing to do that. So I'm out. You know, you have to be a competitor. Like, if you don't want to, like, if you would watch our practices, like, there's friends out there, and they are going at it. And I feel like if you can, you know, there's a lot of times, like, especially with females, I don't know how it is with males, but I feel like they're always competitive, but, like, with females, like, they're friends, and they don't want to compete like that. Like, they don't want to, like, drill their face in.
Yeah.
Like, they don't want.
We struggle with that. Like,
really?
It's like, yes.
Like, I try to explain to my girls, like, when I was in high school, and, you know, like, you have two teams, you're like, okay, we're doing a drill, and the losing team runs. And so I would be doing a drill, and then the losing team would run. Well, I would run with them so I could beat them in the sprint. Like, I wanted them to lose more. Like, I would run into, like, I'm telling you, like, it, like, I don't understand. Like, I don't care if you're my best friend. Like, I want to win. I don't let my kids win at anything. they don't
do you
win.
Think you can teach kids to be
I think so. I say that because I know her kids, and they're all competitive. Like they're
yeah,
all
I
trash
I
talkers, all
so
competitive. Like
no,
I think it's taught. Like 100. Well, I think
I think
your,
it's
like
I think it's in them.
You
and
said you said something there. He's like, I don't let my kids win anything. My dad didn't let me win anything. Nothing. Like absolutely.
Right.
Monopoly didn't matter. Didn't matter what it was. He wouldn't let me win. Like he would not just give me the W. Like. He might make it close, so that could be like competitive. But then at the end, it would be like, "Bam, gotcha."
No, I don't let them win anything. You have to be tough. I mean, I know that's got to be in everything, but like, there's a different, you know. I mean, like, I just like okay, you can't be sick. You can't like the first in the championship game. I think it was the first play. This girl hit that ball, and it. I mean, it. I thought Kinsley's finger was broke. She's like, and I'm like, she's like, can I have some medicine? I'm like, yeah, we get you some medicine, but you know, like we just don't. I mean, she's just shaking it off and going, like you can't.
There's no like throughout our season, like we always kids get sick, and they're like, oh, I got the flu, whatever. I can't come back. I'm like this is the perfect opportunity because there's no guarantee that you're going to be like, not have flu.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. This is an opportunity to push through that train. Figure out how you're going to deal with it because it may happen to you. There's no guarantees that in the state championship you're not like Austin Sweeney's not going to wrestle with a broken hand. Broken hand because he punched the door because he lost. I was like, people were like, he's so dumb, and I was like, that's what I want. Somebody like hates losing so bad that he broke his hand. Like you know what I mean? That's how I feel anytime like I lose. Like want to break my hand, but. There's no guarantee.
But I mean, that's why I'm like, you just gotta. You just cannot be sick. I mean, you're like you. I'll tell my girls. I'm like, you guys, like laying there in your deathbed. You know, is better than you're better laying there like that than these other teams. Like, yeah. So you can't do that. Yeah, Kinsley woke up. I think it was the Houston game, and she woke up and her throat was about closed, and I was like, oh my god. So of course we got some steroids and some. Antibiotics, and I'm like, she just went on out there. I mean, but I could tell, like, in the game, like, there's certain things that I can, you know, you see as a coach, like, you notice your players when you see them day in and out. Like, I could tell. She didn't, like, I can tell she didn't feel good, but, like, you would, like,
just
you
just
know.
When they walk in the room sometimes, I'm like, something ain't right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You know. I mean, you see them every day, you know. And so I knew, but, like, anybody to the normal eye, you would never know that she didn't feel good, but obviously she got better. But you know, you gotta be able to compete. Like no matter what. That's what I would say is you have to be intentional. If you have to be intentional with like what you're doing, how you're training, you know, what you're eating.
That's what you said.
Just being intentional with you know, you don't just like when I played basketball, like I didn't go work out and just shoot the basketball around. I just didn't sit there and shoot. Like I had, and like I would play a game in my mind. I was intentional with how I trained and how I was playing. Like I didn't just stand there and shoot the ball. That's what people think. Like as shooters, oh, you stand out there and shoot. No, I didn't. Like I had I would go game speed and it would be intentional. And so that's the same way, you know, in volleyball, I think you have to be intentional. Or anything with what you do, you have to be intentional.
Yeah, you can't just show up.
You can't just show up. You
can't just show up to class and get an A. You gotta show up to class to work. Like you know what I mean? Like anybody can have perfect attendance and not learn a thing. You know what I mean? So, I love that you said that. That's spot on. Just being very specific, not just. Coming in and showing up and going through the motions, being intentional. What am I getting out of this? Why are we doing this? How can I use this? How can I get better here? What specifically can I do? You know what I mean? Not just
we talk about like in practice, like you know, what is your goal today? You know, like, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to ask you that, but you should be intentional in saying, like, you know, I've said three times to you to cover the corner. and you've yet to cover the corner. So what should your intentions be like? What should you be doing and working on? And that should be your goal. Like I've said it three times. Like I think that, you know, you've got to hear that and make adjustments and do that. So, I mean, I don't ask everybody, what's your goal today in practice? But we talk about
right.
it.
Right. Well, you don't want to be, because then it becomes like monotonous.
Yes.
And it seems like it's not that important if you're like constantly like reminding them of it.
What's
like,
too, like,
right. Yeah.
Right. Well, right. You know, that's what, like, I told them, like, before we went to the championship, you know, when we were talking about, you know, winning owes you nothing. Like, you've gotten here, you've put in more work. I can promise you more than anybody in the state. But that doesn't mean that you're going to win this game. I mean, that doesn't, yeah. like, just entitle you to win the game. Like, right. you know, people put up, I mean, there are some teams, I mean, I didn't feel like there was any there, but there are some teams that put in as much, you know, much work that you do, but that, you know, you've got to go out there and, you know, perform and trust your training and do it. Just because you put in all the work doesn't mean you're going to win. I'm internationally known when I be on the mic. Hardcore. Real hell. I'm internationally known, yo. Hardcore. Real hell. I'm internationally known when I be on the mic. Hardcore. Real hell. So all hell the honorable. It's to my real illness. Heavyweight hitters. Dope. 50 ways to make figures. My they come on the spot to fail sisters. Like the handrail spitters and kids on the ziggas ziggas. When it's ugly, then the club is lovely. Thugs be sipping Hennessy and bubbly. To my comrade, they keep it flaming hot. On dangerous blocks, claiming spots. Where the goal is to be one of the top ranked soldiers. One of the high rollers, get respect in the hood. Credit is good. Knock it down, lumberjack style, baby. Extra wood. Rock it all night long. The bangathon, baby. Keep hanging on. We like it with the lights on. Don't have to blow 20 down to get to know honey style. Show her the town, steal her heart, no money down.